Shellie.
Doesn't really make you feel that special to win a prize, and your prize is you get to sit with the touchdown club. Everybody loves it. Coach Napier, Ms. Napier, it's good to have you with us tonight. We love having Alabama coaches at the touchdown club, but for whatever reason, no one ever seems to come back. I understand from Greg that you have a 1- and 3-year-old at home. So sitting beside John, David, and Bill must have been a lot like being around the family at dinner table. I know everyone here is wondering, has Coach Saban hung his stocking by the chimney with carrot? It's sure been a couple of great weeks for the Tide. Derrick Henry won the 81st Heisman Trophy on Saturday night. In no small part, that happened because he broke Herschel Walker's single-season SEC rushing record by rushing 1,986 yards. The Tide finished ranked number 2 in the college football playoff standings. And Alabama takes on the 3rd-rated Michigan State Spartans in the Goodyear Cotton Bowl on New Year's Eve. Coach, I know you're on the offensive side, but when you think about Michigan State football this year, you have to remember that incredible come-from-behind victory over Michigan on a kicking error by the Wolverines special teams just as time was about to expire. I'm trying to remember if I've ever seen a game between in-state rivals that ended so quickly on a score following a kicking error. To make notes. By the way, Lynn, I'm just wondering if that $1 is an Alabama alum, if that $1 for the yard sale was to buy the entire yard. Okay. Well, if those achievements were enough to keep the Tide faithful happy, I think Alabama is just one of 10 teams in the Power 5 conferences that didn't fire its head coach this year. Lots of coaching changes this season. Miami, Virginia Tech, Virginia, Missouri, Georgia, Southern Cal, Maryland, Illinois, just to name a few. It was even rumored that LSU would replace the dean of SEC coaches, Les Miles, if he lost to Texas A&M. Even at South Carolina, a bastion of stability, we have a new head ball coach, a former Florida coach in Auburn, D.C., Will Muschamp. It was a natural choice for the Gamecocks. I haven't even gotten to the punchline yet. You can't spell Muschamp without USC. You also may remember that before going to Florida, Muschamp was the so-called coach in waiting at Texas. Of course, today that position is filled by Tom Herman at Houston. It's a pretty smart move by Texas because you get another team to pay the salary of your future coach. The Liberty Bowl got its team. The return of the Arkansas Razorbacks to the Liberty Bowl for a record fifth time, portends great things for this year's event. Post-game surveys of the Razorback Nation following their 2010 Liberty Bowl appearance showed a base of nearly 15,000 fans who attended just for the experience of indoor plumbing.
Wait a minute. And it was clean, too.
81 bids were extended this year to fill 42 bowl games, including the national championship game. As you know, a record of 6-6 or better is needed automatically to qualify, although the Nebraska Cornhuskers are going to the Foster Farms Bowl. So sometimes you don't even need a punchline. The Minnesota Gophers, Golden Gophers, will be in the Quick Lane Bowl, and the San Jose State Spartans in the Autonation Cure Bowl were needed to fill out the schedule. And where you, if you had less than 6 wins, then the academic progress rate for your school was used to break ties. And hard to believe that Nebraska was at the head of the academic progress roll. At any rate, the NCAA says that we may be reaching the point where there are too many bowls, and they're going to have to figure this out. There are actually 3 new bowls for next year. The Austin Bowl, which was to be played this year, won't be played until next year, and then two entirely new bowls were certified for 2016. I don't know, have any heard the Knoxville Bowl? Anyone heard this? Okay. It's better known by its technical name, the Super Poly Grip Bowl. And finally, Dearborn, Michigan will host the first Sharia Law Bowl. The NCAA is going to experiment with a little deal there where both teams will defend the end of the field facing Mecca. Just a few final things. Congratulations to the Memphis Tigers football team for a 9-3 season, which included an upset of Sugar Bowl-bound Ole Miss. I understand Kroger's renewed their ticket support agreement for another year. Had Memphis gone undefeated, there were rumors that Whole Foods would provide next season's $5 tickets. Memphis also hired Mike Norvell from Arizona State, who becomes the youngest coach of a football bowl subdivision team. And Memphis will play Auburn in the December 30 historic Birmingham Bowl. It's intriguing to me to think what the Tigers' postseason destination might have been had they not missed the last-second field goal at Houston, or had Coach Fuente not taken the Virginia Tech job right after the win over Ole Miss. And speaking of the Ole Miss Rebel Bears, can I get a Da Bears?
Da Bears!
The participation of star defensive lineman Robert Kenducci in the Sugar Bowl may be in doubt. I think we all expected Kenducci to go early, the assumption, of course, being it would be in the draft and not to jail. According to reports in the Atlanta News, Kenducci has been arrested and charged with marijuana possession after he was injured by jumping off a ledge outside the window of his room at the Grand Hyatt in Buckhead. I don't know about you, when I was in college, I used to spend a lot of nights at the Grand Hyatt in Buckhead. You know, I don't know what Kenducci's vertical jump ascending is, but we do know now that he can do at least a 15-foot descending. The Atlanta police report says it's undetermined why or how Mr. Kenducci made it over two ledges onto the ground. Neither Mr. Kenducci nor his 7 associates would provide this information. I was thinking to myself, I bet at Alabama guys have buddies, teammates, friends, classmates, but only at Ole Miss does one have 7 associates. At Monday's press conference, today's press conference, Coach Freeze said there's no cut and dry answer to these details until you figure out what you're dealing with. I guess it goes through the process. Coach Freeze said he would not decide the playing status until getting all the facts. And as we all know, Ole Miss has been in the people helping business for a long time. At least if the people are football players. But as Coach Freeze said at his news conference about the Kenducci brothers, obviously I haven't helped them enough. Just one final thing. I don't know how many of you have been following this little controversy at the University of Tennessee, but the UT Office of Diversion and Inclusion has concluded that pronouns such as he, his, her, it, should be replaced by gender-neutral pronouns. For example, instead of he, his, we should have Z, Zer, and Zers. What I found most amazing is that there was any significant number of students at the University of Tennessee who knew what a gender-neutral pronoun was.
Oh!
Thank you very much.